Hello children, welcome back to third part of the chapter Food and Digestion. So, in the previous video, we learnt about the different nutrients that we get in the food. Those are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. So, apart from that, as we discussed in the previous video, that apart from that we have something called as roughage and water in food. So we'll discuss about that in this video. So when we eat foods like cereals, fresh vegetables, fruits and salads, not all is taken into the body. Remember, complete food is not carb. It doesn't, all complete food that we eat doesn't contain only carbohydrates, fats, minerals, proteins, vitamins and other things. It also contains, children, the other things that are called as roughages, as you can see here, right? It also contains other things called as roughages, right? As you can see, there is a circle. So this type of presentation is called as pie chart, right? You'll learn about this in higher classes in mathematics. So as you can see, we have a black portion. So if this pie chart is 100%, right? Total 100% of your food. In that, what we can say, some 20% or 15% of food is roughage. So, what is the use of this roughage? Why do we need this roughage to be there? Let us see, children. Right? Its function is to move waste throughout the stomach and out of the body. Right? Remember, children, the food that we eat completely never gets converted into energy. Remember, just like when you put petrol to your bike, right? All the petrol is not burnt and converted into energy. You see no smoke coming out of the exhaust of your vehicles, of cars, bikes, lorries, trucks, buses. In the same way, complete food that we eat, in that part of wastage is present. That wastage has to be moved out of the body. So that is done by roughages. Roughages helps us to move the waste to the stomach and out of the body. So that's why roughages are very important to remove the waste from the stomach. And another thing, as I told, roughage, the food also contains water. So during the day, we lose some water from our body in the form of sweat, right? Especially more in summer, or if you play, or if you run, or if you do a lot of physical activity, you will get a lot of sweat. And urination, right? While urinating, we lose water. And some part of the water is utilized by body for doing various activity inside our body, right? So that's why we need to drink at least 6 to 8 glasses of water every day, depending on your age. Adult means people who are 18 years above, at least 4 to 5 liters of water they have to drink. So approximately what we can say, if one glass of water is around half liter or 300 ml, so what doctor suggests, at least 6 to 8 full glass of water will keep your body healthy. And why is water so important to keep our body healthy? That is very important thing. Why is it so much important, water? See, most of the food that we eat, children, especially fruits and vegetables, right? They contain lot of water. We have eaten so many fruits, right? For example, watermelon, orange, pomegranate, grapes, apple. They have so much of water in them. And when you come to vegetables, can you remember any examples? Tomato, right? Cucumber, right? And you can go on adding up. And carrot, right? Many vegetables, they have a lot of water in them. So our body needs water for proper digestion and good health. That is why we need to drink water on regular basis, children, right? So food, first thing, water keeps our body cool, very important thing. It keeps our body cool and it also helps in proper digestion of the food that we heat, and if we heat sufficient quantity of water, then it we will be healthy. See, that is a lot of difference between drinking lot of water and sufficient water, right? What is sufficient water? The water that is sufficient for your body, children. So our body needs lot of water, means sufficient quantity of water for good digestion and good health, children. So as I told, we saw something called as balanced diet in the starting of the chapter. So what is a balanced diet, children? Let us see that. A food you eat is called as a diet. Remember, whatever food you eat is called as a diet. Then what do you mean by balanced diet? So balanced diet, as you can see, there are 4 points there, right? So what does a balanced diet mean, children? Right? Enough energy from carbohydrates and little fat. That is very important. You should have a food that contains more carbohydrates, because you do lot of physical work, moving around in and out, right? And the food that we eat should have little amount of fat. And it should have enough proteins that helps in bodybuilding and repair of the body. And enough vitamins and mineral salts to, right? Enough vitamins and mineral salts to help you grow properly and keep healthy. And enough water and roughage. So you have to plan your diet in such a way you get all these things. That is called as a balanced diet, children. Right? So about digestion, we will be seeing in the next video. Thank you, children.